So I'm going to show you how to create an event in Calendly, and you can link it to Zoom so that when people book a time, that's a time that you're available. So we're going to create the meeting. It could be just a one-off meeting, but in fact, I'm actually going to say, now this is an event type, which is the kind of thing that I want people to book regularly with me. And that's going to be a one-on-one call in this case. The event name, we're just going to call it 90-day planning session. The location is going to be, actually, this one is going to be through Zoom. You can link to Teams, to Zoom. Obviously, it could be a physical location too, but I'm going to link it to Zoom. If you're wondering how to do that, check out this video below, which shows you how to integrate Zoom and Calendly. Instructions or description that is going to appear in the invitation. And so the shortcut is the 90-day planning session. And so that's going to be the event link that people can simply click to book a time. Click on next here. And this allows you to say when you are available. Now you can do all kinds of fancy things with your existing schedule, or you can set some custom hours. I'm just going to go with the default hours here. Do you want to have some buffer time to prepare for the event so that you don't have two back-to-back calls? You might say, yeah. And then for that matter, after the event, I want to allow myself an extra 15 minutes to just for the event to run a little bit over time, or for me to send off some information after our call. Now, the next bit is really interesting. This is particularly helpful, is the invitee questions. And what this allows you to do is ask them some questions. Obviously, we're going to need to know their name and their email address. We always have to do that for them to be able to get the invitation for Calendly, but there may be some other questions that you could ask. Now, this is very generic. Please share anything that will help prepare for our meeting, but you could make that more specific. Now what I recommend you do is give them a little bit of confidence ahead of the meeting that you are a good fit. So if you do ask questions, try not to make it too much work for them ahead of time to prepare for the meeting. In fact, you can make the questions optional or required. So you might be asking a question like this: how long have you been running a business? Now, some of them may be saying, well, actually, I haven't even started yet. Now, that could be one line, or you might even suggest, hey, this is, haven't started yet. A side gig, you know, less than 1 year. One to 3 years. So you get the idea. They get to choose one of these options, okay? And for that matter, you could ask them, you know, you've got another option such as other, if you want them to fill that in. We can click apply there. And so that's a kind of simple question that you might ask them that doesn't create friction. And it does also give you something to help you prepare for your meeting. You can ask other questions as well. The idea here of these questions is really to make it more welcoming for them, to make them, give them more incentive to come, to turn up for your meeting, and also to tell them that you are professional, that you are going to use your time well on your first call. And perhaps even to hint at a follow-up action that you're going to take at the end of the meeting. Now, if you want, you could include some other things such as a free 2-minute video or something that is going to help them to be, hey, I'm really, really glad that I have booked this meeting. That's the idea. Okay. Now, we're not going to go into confirmation page or collecting payments or anything like that at the moment. I just wanted to show you that that is how you can create an event really easily. And then if we view the live page, this is what the clients get to see. Now, I've just gone with the default. I've got a huge availability, which probably indicates that I'm not very busy. And so it might be better to narrow that down a little bit. And then people can then book a time. And so people can then book a time. This is going to be in their local time. And then at that point, they get to enter their details, share anything that will prepare. So we kept that question very generic. And then how long have you been running a business? And here is where you can say whichever answer it is that you want to put in. And then you click on schedule event. That will send them an invitation to your meeting. So send them a calendar invitation, which they can then add to their calendar. And it will also include a link to their Zoom meeting if you've got it integrated with Zoom, if you've got Calendly and Zoom integrated together.